Dear Danny, I'm taking the pen in me hand to tell you we're just out of sight of the land. In a big anchor liner, we're sailing in style, and we're sailing from the Emerald Isle. Oh, a strange sort of sigh seems to come from us all as the waves hit the last bit of our Donegal. Sure, it's good to be you that is taking your tay where they're cutting the corn around Chrysla the day. Sure, I spoke to the captain and he won't turn around, and if I swam back I'd be apt to be drowned. So I'll stay where I am, for the diet is great, and there's lots of combustibles piled on me plate. Although it is sumptuous, sure I'd swap the whole lot for the owl wooden spoon and the stir about pot. Oh, and Kitty furnenced me a wetting the tay where they're cutting the corn around Chrysla the day. There's a woman on board that knows Kitty by sight, and we talked of old times till they put out the lights. I'm to meet the good woman tomorrow on deck, and we'll talk about Kitty from here to Quebec. Sure, I know I'm no match for her, no, not the least, with her house and two cows and her brother a priest. But the woman declares Kitty's heart's on the say, while mine's with the reapers round Chrysla the day. Ah, goodbye to you, Danny, there's no more to be said, for I think the salt water's got into me head, and it drips from me eyes when I call to me mind the friends and the colleagues I'm leaving behind. And sure, Kitty herself, when she bade me goodbye, had just the slight trace of a tear in her eye, and a break in her voice when she said you might stay, but please God I'll come back to Owl Chrysla some.